Alright troops, welcome back to the Don's channel. I am the Don Father and I'm about to do a reaction for a patron of ours, Marine Jason Phillips, and his 8-year-old son who likes the channel too. Thanks very much to both of you for the support. And Jason has requested Lay Me Down in the Cold Cold Ground, or Lay Me Down in the Cold Cold Grun, just depends on where you are. In Scotland, the different accents for it. This song obviously features in We Were Soldiers with Mel Gibson for Sergeant McKenzie, isn't it? And the pipes in it, let me tell you, they take you on a journey, they get you emotional, they get under your skin, tug on those heartstrings. There's something about the bagpipes, I think, nobody can deny. They have that raw emotional feeling to them, don't they, 100%, particularly in a tune played like this. And the lyrics to the song as well, obviously being based on war, soldiers dying on the battlefield, etc. It just adds that extra dimension to the emotion of it. So, the link to the original video will be in the description section below. If you'd like to become a patron and get a personalised video request and shout out, check that out in the description section too, or simply just join the channel as a member. You can join by on any of the videos, there'll be a join button, or simply go onto the channel page and join from there to get your personalised video requests and shout out. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. That would be fantastic. Put the bell on so you don't miss any future uploads. Thanks very much, Jason and your son. I hope you enjoy the reaction. No more talking then. Let's go.
In the cold, cold grin. many men have gone. Lay me down in the cold, cold grin. Wherefore many men have gone. Wherefore many men have gone.
Powerful little video, and let me tell you something, it didn't need to show you anything from the battlefield. It's just something just so emotional about just seeing the constant rows of headstones for all the fallen soldiers. Some of them actually on the gravestones were saying long life, so they're getting a military style burial as well, which is lovely to see. That's in Tennessee, that cemetery. Excuse me, so anybody who's obviously served gets to be buried there, which is a lovely fitting tribute that they're doing over there in the United States. But the tune, it just gets inside you, the words, and I appreciate, obviously, I understand what the words are saying and what it means, but for people that doesn't have an ear for the old Scots dialect like that, there is a video on YouTube for Lay Me Down in the Cold, Cold Ground where it's like the Scots and also the English words, what it would be saying in English if you're struggling to make out what those words mean. It might actually help you to, when you hear the pipes, if you go back and you're watching that video, you start to learn the words, it might make it even more emotional for you. I would imagine it would. Because just as I say, it just tugs on the heartstrings. There's something about when the bagpipes started the song and ended it. My hair's just stood up in my arms, and the goosebumps, it puts a shiver down your spine, doesn't it? It just gets inside you. And as I say, that request, I really appreciate that. Of course, everybody knows that I'll always pay tribute and respect to fallen soldiers, serving soldiers, and of course people living with sort of mental health problems from their time in the military, or maybe even if they're still serving to this day. Definitely one for supporting the veterans on this channel, 100%. That doesn't matter if you're United States, Canadian, Australian, British, any of the Commonwealth, Allied military, I'll always show respect to. That's not to say that, look here, I know if you're fighting an enemy, they're doing their job, you're doing your job, they're fighting for what their country stands for or believes in, and likewise you're doing the same thing. So there's an element of respect to anybody who's going to serve their country and fight and die for it. They're paying the ultimate sacrifice, or they're willing to pay the ultimate sacrifice, so you've got to have respect there. You can't show no humanity towards them whatsoever. And as I say, they're willing to do things. Many of people in countries that are living in freedom, like United States, like Britain, like that, would never do. They would never go and fight for their country and serve their country. So when you disrespect your enemy, you're actually, you need to have good reason for doing it. You need to be willing to put yourself in their shoes for your own country as well before you can ever dishonour somebody else and show no respect to them. And as I say, they're just doing their job and fighting for what their country believes in. It just might be on the other side of what you believe in. So that's all I have to say on that. But thanks very much for the request, Jason. I greatly appreciate it as always. I hope you and your son liked the reaction. Of course, it's not much that you want to say during that track. You're just listening, going, it takes you into deep thought, maybe reminiscing on your own things in your own life or whatever, or maybe you've got a family member that passed away fighting in a war, and it brings back remembrance for you in that front. But yeah, it's just one of those songs, isn't it? It takes you on a journey back, and it's packed with emotion, isn't it? 100%. Anyway, the link to the original video will be in the description section below, but I do urge you to check out. If you didn't understand what those lyrics were meaning, do check out the Old Scots dialect translated in the same video with the English language, if you like, because it isn't something that everybody understands. Of course, I will understand it, and maybe some people in America would understand it, but it is difficult to pick up. Even Scots nowadays don't actually speak with that kind of dialect, really. It's not so much spoken anymore. It's not as mainstream or widespread anymore as it would have been back in the day, because I think in Scotland you've got three kind of languages in Scotland. You had the Old Scots Gaelic, you've had the Old Scots dialect, and of course the English language as well, which is probably the most predominant language in Scotland. Well, it is the most predominant language in Scotland now, but still spoken with a degree of Scottish slang. Obviously, it depends on what region you're at. You're living in Scotland, what your slang words would be, what your accent would sound like, and that goes without saying. What words etc. you use as well. So yeah, like, check that out, and check out our Patreon, or join the channel if you'd like a personalised video request and shout out. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share, and put the bell on as well so you don't miss any of our uploads. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.